A. Malcolm X L. That's a big pun, bigger punishment. I give him hell. Getting done. Keep it blunt enough. You can't cough drop. Tell them hard for their health.
Al fin han encontrado el negrito con los colorados, el mejor desde Colombia a los estados. Pa' los que no piensan que yo soy mejor, tengo todo, tu rapero favorito paniqueado, te cuidado. Estos raperos son mis hijos jautados. Acuérdate que ni hizo el sonido que te ha gustado. Pídeme permiso when you copy my style. This bridge, I done burnt them all with a freestyle. Black on both sides de Colombia, oye peep style. Como yo lo hago, ain't nobody funny, do it now. Up the uptown, all the way down through the south. No hay nadie que pueda conmigo, Dios es mi testigo. I'm the one that shut it down. Just a light from a vision that I had in the dark. Tunnel vision on the bigger picture, the charts. Wanna play the game, but don't never play they part.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Las Vegas, Nevada. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Miami Dolphins and the Las Vegas Raiders. And we are underway at Allegiant Stadium. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more. Now the first carry for Chase Edmonds.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
Second down and another run with Edmonds. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
And a little floater there is incomplete.
I think he could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Tua sets up to pass it. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive. Once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
They'll run on first down, Edmonds. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. yards for a net gain of nothing. Now here's third and 10. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And the Raiders are going to take possession of the football. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. A Raider first down, 17 yards. They fake the handoff. Now Carr. Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And the Dolphins are going to get the football here as he gets this up past the 20-yard line. Unfortunately for him, if last week was any indication, we knew a pick was coming at some point. Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point. Fingers, all right, because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician, but you're right, it felt like a matter of time, and you've got to think the guys on defense, they couldn't wait for this opportunity after what they saw on tape.
A gain of three, second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through, no place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a three-yard gain.
Nowhere to go that time. Might have gotten a yard up to the 25. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. Tua finding Gesicki there for a Dolphin first.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. First carry for Raheem Mostert. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
And the pressure gets there, and Tua is going to be taken down. Max Crosby in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. The Dolphins will send out the punter now as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt. And it'll be Raiders football first and 10. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. The partner just looking at some of the struggles they've had this season. The playoffs are not in their future. As they start to peer toward the offseason, what moves might they make?
I think the running back position, and I know we talk all the time about the NFL being a passing league, but the teams that run the ball effectively, they're the ones that go deep into the playoffs and go to the Super Bowl. They have to upgrade here. And you and I both know in recent years in the draft, people have shied away from taking a runner early, but there's that special one there, I say they go get it.
17 yards is the pickup there for number 17. In motion comes the tight end left. Now a play fake. Carr. The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Emmanuel Ogba. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw up a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Carr completes it. Second quarter from Vegas. The home standing Raiders with a football here. No score after one on EA Sports. Throwing his car on third down. Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 31-yard line. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory, down at the 31. Carr. Over the middle, complete. It's Adams. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. That's now four completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he gets halfway home from the 10 to the 5 on a pickup of 5. Here comes play number 9 now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Play action. Now it's Carr. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And the Dolphins are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line.
Partner, there's no other way you could describe it because that was absolutely just gut-wrenching for that offense. They were right on the precipice. Points were available. All they had to do was just fall forward, and they were going to put them up on the board. Instead, a long drive ends in heartbreak and a melancholy trip back to the drawing board. I like it when I go a little bit lyrical for you.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Oh, the ball comes out on the hip.
There's a lot about that play you could easily see coming. Backed up in the shadow of their own goal line, you know they're going to face pressure.
He's lucky his arm was going forward. It was close, but it was going forward.
Yeah, it could have been a safety or even given up a defensive touchdown.
Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Raiders will have a short field to work with as they take over. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Buying time to his left. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now 2nd down.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play. And he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
Now, quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
Dropped incompletions on 1st and 2nd down. It certainly seems like a reflection of what we've seen so far in this game. The defense, quicker to the punch so far. Let's see if they can get something going here on 3rd down.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Throwing now is Carr. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And he is going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. On first and 10, here's Carr. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Jones. And the Raiders are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after.
And he's in! Touchdown, Raiders! A great effort there! His fifth rushing touchdown now on the year. And the Raiders post the first points of the ballgame as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
To Edmonds on the toss. Taken down at the 42. He really hasn't been able to get on track running the football, averaging less than 4 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think that they're going to enjoy the film session because all the defenders are filling their proper gaps on just about every play. And you know what they always say for a defensive coach? When I click off this film, I better see 11 jerseys in the picture going after the ball carrier.
They'll run right side with Mostert, and he'll get maybe a couple before he's taken down, as that will take us to the 2-minute warning. And the Raiders call on a nickel set here for third down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, this first half has not gone according to plan so far, offensively, or even defensively for that matter. They could use a big-time spark somewhere, but it's not going to come on this drive as they have to punt this one away.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, are we just going to do ball control? This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense.
After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11. To throw, it's Carr. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football. Well, this is just crazy. He's got 3 interceptions, Charles, and we haven't even departed the first half of this ballgame.
I think if you're looking at the stats right now, you're saying, all right, who's the leading receiver? Well, can you flip it around and say that maybe he is and could be for the game the way that things are going right now? I think if it's him, he wants to be on the field at all times.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
This defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into errant throws. Everything they're doing has been executed well.
And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one.
And that's a play that's not uncommon on third and long because the offense is just hoping that somehow they can get a guy in space and follow some blockers downfield. Does a pretty nice job there getting a few yards, but he ends up getting stopped before he can get the first down.
They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Tua going to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. Touchdown! A great play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Dolphins are on the board here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And they've got a little under 40 seconds to go if they want to try to put something together here. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there. Second down.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again. Second and 10 from the 25. Here's Carr. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Emmanuel Ogba. That is now two sacks for him here in this first half. Now Charles dealing with a third and long. They'll have to try to go back to the air again and this time avoid the sack.
Certainly hard to try to establish momentum when all you're doing is going backwards, not protecting the passer, and he gets dumped on his backside.
Carr and the Raiders following the sack, looking up at a third and long. Carr now to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. On fourth down, A.J. Cole comes on to punt. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And the punt goes out of bounds. Where will they put it? They'll put it just inside the 45-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And with decent starting field position, they're maybe only a couple completions away from field goal range. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
They gave it a shot with a deep pass, but it wasn't going to work there. And now there's less time for them to try and get three before the half. Let's see what they dial up on this next snap.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here's Tua. On the screen, this is Edmonds. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Tua, the final shot before half. Got a man, it's Waddle complete. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So we've reached halftime here on New Year's Eve as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the final two quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of Week 17 is underway. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Right back to him on first down. Byron Jones in there to make the tackle.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
And some room to work. And good vision there as he's across midfield and down to the 45-yard line. 52 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Carr now on first down. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked up by Javon Holland. And he will bring it back. It's a pick 6 and a Dolphins touchdown. So what a turn of events there. You're driving to take the lead in this third quarter, but then one mistake, and you're watching the ball being returned for a touchdown.
Certainly a great example of how focus has to be there on every play, doesn't it, partner? You can't get complacent, and I think that he did. He's got him moving downfield, but that's a play where he just shouldn't have thrown the football, and it ultimately could wind up costing him the ball game.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick 6, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick 6 and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack to about the 40-yard line.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Carr gonna throw. He's got a man. It's his fullback. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And that'll leave him with a 3rd and just 1 yard.
It's pretty easy to overlook the fullback when you're making your assignments defensively in the pass coverage game. But in this case, they made him pay for that oversight and picks up a nice gain.
Carr to throw on 3rd and 1. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Partner, for once in my life, I'll be succinct. In a one possession game, every single stop like that could be a difference maker.
Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he is going to have a Raiders first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. A big roll of the dice on 4th and 1, but it pays off. They convert. That fourth down decision, unconventional but effective, and they indeed come up now with a first and 10, a fresh set of downs. Meanwhile, Carr's throw taken in by Adams. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. And a nice milestone reached on that last throw is here late in the season. He goes over 4,000 yards passing.
And he's really thrown the ball well all season long, had some big games along the way. He's inspired his receiving corps to go out and make plays for him in each and every ball game.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
And Waller taking it in over the middle, and he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line.
He's certainly done a nice job spreading the field on this drive, and here he finds his big tight end for good yardage. And that's what you have to do. Keep defenses guessing about where you're going to go with the football.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy is nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. This is Lazard with a catch out left. Touchdown, Raiders! Alan Lazard, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Raiders are an extra point away now from moving out in front. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And that will put them on top here in the 3rd. On is the Raider kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. And this is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Play action, now it's Tua. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to convert, albeit not by much, on 3rd and 1 yard.
There you go, partner. That's some old school football right there. You need 1 yard? Give it to your bruiser fullback and let him get the job done.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Now a give to Mostert running right. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
From the 40 now on 2nd down, Tua. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on 3rd down.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
So the failure to connect on 2nd down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Now Tua. Got a man complete to Cedric Wilson. And he's going to have another 1st down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 39. Edmonds running out of the shotgun. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On second down, Mostert. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
2nd and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
From the 24, Tua. And his throw is incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
This drive, they're 2 for 2 on third down conversions, but they need 7 yards here. Now Tua just going to bat this forward on the end around. And he does not get to the first down marker as they stop him at the 19.
Now they did get a little gain on this play, but all in all, a nice job defensively against the touch pass. They were able to string it out towards the sideline and never let him get the corner and turn it upfield for a bigger chunk of yardage.
So he waited on the sideline for his first chance in the ballgame, and it didn't come until the fourth quarter, but he connects there, a big one, to give him the lead.
Boy, you talk about coming in cold. I don't care how many times you kick it into a net. You're not really ready when you go out there and all that beef is coming at you trying to block the kick. Big spot, and he delivers.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ballgame. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4. And this offense on third down today, 2 for 5 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. 94 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
But sometimes, Brandon, there's just not a secret to how things get done. He's been running well all game long, and they continue to rely on him in this key situation.
They told us they were going to rely on him. They have. He comes through there, a big third down conversion. Now they'll throw with Carr. On the out route, this is Adams with a catch. He's got room at the 30. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Devontae Adams, 55 yards. And the Raiders use the defensive breakdown to take the lead away here in the fourth. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And the lead is up to 5. Is the Raider kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the fourth quarter.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Looking to pass. Tua dancing to his left. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
But based on the play we just saw there, he might not be the guy you want to challenge in coverage on these all-important snaps. He certainly looks dialed in right now.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now fourth down.
Good clean play. No flags coming out of the pocket of the officials. Turns into an incompletion. And that should get them off the field with a three and out.
Fourth down, fourth quarter. Here's Tua. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And the Raiders with the football now in excellent field position. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play. Second down.
Well, partner, Marvin, our number one stats guy, just handed me a little card that says he has 97 yards on the ground today. You think he's going to get the ball again?
I think so. Three away from that century mark, got to have it.
Yeah, and I think what they're going to call is one of his favorite runs, whatever he feels comfortable with, and what the offensive line has executed well today to try and get him over 100 yards.
No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. And some room to maneuver. Touchdown! Third touchdown pass now for Derek Carr. And the Raiders look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Now Blankenship on for the PAT. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. So the same result, had he opted for the touchback. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Yeah, the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And the Raiders are going to take possession of the football. Getting close, and that interception there on the deep ball, that probably slams the door on their chances.
And maybe that was the thought process, that it wasn't quite desperation time. So now you take the shot before they're going to lay back any farther on defense. Go ahead and throw it downfield. Unfortunately, it didn't work.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
Oh, nice defensive effort there, providing the hit as the ball got to the receiver, separates him from the catch, and normally he's a sure-handed target.
Now here's a throw that's complete, and they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. Looking to throw on third and two. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. They've got a fourth down here in a game that looks to have been decided already. Carr going to go on fourth down. Able to find Walter. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Not a whole lot there on first and goal, and that's what you're looking for defensively. You'll certainly live with giving up just a yard or two in this situation.
Carr gonna throw here. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal. On play action, it's Carr. Steps away. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
That's a really nice job there by the coverage, understanding that they're in a high-stakes situation. If he doesn't make a play on that ball, there's an excellent chance it ends up either as a touchdown or as a nice gain downfield.
Blankenship's kick is good. So after 4 touchdowns in the game for this offense, this time they're forced into taking the 3.
But you did mention 4 touchdowns, right? So 4 out of 5, not too bad. I think that's a pretty good record for them.
And this is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And he returns this to the 22. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And this offense trying to change the script here a little bit, CD. Trailing on the scoreboard in the last timeout, on the very first play of the drive, they threw that interception.
And you definitely saw his coaches, teammates come over to him on the sideline, trying to help him shake it off, because in this game, his team is down right now. So it's important to make sure you get some confidence back for both the quarterback and the entire offense. Otherwise, those mistakes could continue to pile up.
His throw is taken in by Waddle. And he'll get him a first down up past the 40 as the clock ticks on. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. Tagovailoa. That's complete to Edmonds, his running back. And he's got room. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
This will be caught. It's Waddle. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
Now Tua. And it's caught. He's got it for a late touchdown. Probably a little too late. It would take a miracle of epic proportions if they're going to pull this one off. And now in a 9-point game, they'll still just need to go for 1 here. Yeah, the pressure gets there, and Tua is going to be taken down.
Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there. Didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare him to do that? What was
that? Maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film with those to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
Carr down to a knee, and that ought to just about do it.
Well, this was a very close ball game at halftime, Charles, but in the second half, that offense kind of kicked things into another gear, and they were able to pull away for the victory.
And, Brandon, I think they're the type of team that just looked in the mirror and said, hey, ton of